When I was talking with Adam, he asked me to participate on this. I was struggling to find what it will be a good topic in order to talk about. I mean, there is so many cool projects that we're working on that it was difficult for me to pick one. So I sort of cheated and I picked a bunch of them. And I'm just going to give you a small pick, like a really simple thing about what my team is doing. So let me introduce myself first. My name is Felipe Perez. I'm a senior machine learning researcher at Layer 6, and I have the privilege to lead one of the teams in the company. So in case that you don't know, Layer 6 has been around for a while. I think one of the things that they did in order to show a strength before I was part of the team was they won the Rexis Challenge in 2017. And that shows like how good their code and their data science was. And therefore, they got acquired by TD. The whole acquisition was basically to bring state-of-the-art capabilities to TD Bank, which we have done, and we're really happy with the results we have had so far. Now, but the company keep going, and you will always participate in competitions, as we will see later. Rexis being one that is close to our heart, and we like to participate in it. And we went from having 13 employees on 2018 to having more than 60. I think we're about 65, 66 by now from 17 different countries. We are growing and we're always hiring. It's always fun to see how the company has grown. All right, so, but what do we do? And this is tricky because we like AI, we like machine learning, we like all these things, but we actually like to see it from all the possible faces that it has. One of the things that we do is we do research. We publish a lot and we like to push the state of the art. We like to be in the frontier there, battling the same as with any researcher, academic researcher, and trying to push the boundaries. It's pretty cool, and I'll tell you more about those projects later. But as mentioned before, we like competitions, like Kaggle like competitions, Rexis challenges, and all like conference competitions. We like them a lot. It's a way to actually, as most of you should know, like there is a huge difference between academia and production. In production, you need a different set of skills, and you can actually find many of those skills in the competitions. So we like to keep those skills sharp, and that's what we use competitions for. We always end up in the top places. But all this expertise that we gain either from academia or from the competitions, we need to bring back, and we bring back that knowledge in two different ways. Towards use cases that we do for TD Bank, where we deliver value in real products and real applications that TD has regarding machine learning. Unfortunately, I won't be able to tell you anything but generics about those applications. I can tell you that that we have brought a lot of value back to the company, but I cannot give you details, unfortunately. But something else I won't be able to tell you much, but I do want to mention is we also build infrastructure. Some competitions have particular challenges that have to do with how you write your code, how you develop your code. There's only so much that you can do with the public libraries. If you're using sklearn or Spark or whatever thing is out there, there's only so much that you can do. Once you write your own code, you will be able to do much more and much more efficient. And we do a lot of that. I'll tell you more in a bit. So here is the part that I was telling you about research. We do research in all fields of machine learning, from computer vision, natural language processing, reinforcement learning, recommender systems, any kind of applications. And recently we had started doing federated learning as well. We publish in journals like Neurips, ICML, iClear, CVPR, and all these companies. We have several papers in collaboration with professors from the Vector Institute and other universities. We also collaborate with other organizations, usually in pro bono kind of things. We have even collaborated with the Raptors. So it's pretty fun, the kind of things that we do. One of the things, some of the papers that we have, like you can see them on the right. If you go to our webpage, you will find many more. But I want to tell you at least a little bit of each of the papers that have been part of my team. I'm really lucky to be working with these guys. They have taught me a lot of stuff, and some of them are really fun. Like, for example, we have this paper where we are, like, if you consider a quantum computer, this thing is far, in my opinion, is far from being realistic, usable, but it's fun to understand it, and it's far to see how much we can push it. in order to have better development on quantum computers, it's good to have simulators to see if the quantum computers are behaving the way they are supposed to behave. Now, we were able, in collaboration with a professor from Vector Institute, his name is Juan Felipe Carrasquilla, we were able to create a transformer model to simulate how the quantum computers work. It was pretty cool because he uses a lot of stats tricks, a lot of sampling tricks, to be more precise. But that, then there was another paper that is close to my heart that is called TFixUp, and it's a better initialization for transformers. This paper has a really peculiarity. Like, when you look at the transformer architecture, there's actually some sort of inefficiency. Like, if you look at the layer norm, actually, you should see the CamDia talk that I gave last time because I think it was about this paper. You can remove the layer norms, and you can actually obtain better performance in the transformer, and you can go much deeper as long as you properly initialize the transformer. But we also work in the recommender system space, where we could use a combination of convolutional neural network, sorry, graph convolutions and graph networks combined with hyperbolic space. Hyperbolic space has this beautiful mathematical property that as long as that the volume of the space increases exponentially in the embedding dimension, and that allows you to fit, to put more objects, users, and items in a lower dimensional space and being more separated. So like a little bit of metric learning in that space combined with the aggregated information that you obtain from graph convolution and networks gives this beautiful performance. Finally, the last paper I want to talk about is called the two-headed attention fuse autoencoder, blah, 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 blah. What is pretty cool about this paper is you can combine information from text reviews and implicit feedback matrices, like the usual recommender setup, as long as you fuse them in the right way. And furthermore, by having two heads, two decoders, pointing to different parts of what makes a recommender system better, one is reducing the bias that happens because of popularity, and the other one is just to actually tailored towards the user, you create a really personalized recommender system that performs much better than if you don't take the text into account. And it will, at the time of publication of this paper, it was the state of the art. I think it's still the state of the art in that setting. So those are some of the projects of my team. There are many more. There are some that we are sending to the journals right now, and we are hoping that everything goes okay. And we'll keep you posted about those. But let me tell you a little bit about competitions. So the competitions we have participated has been the YouTube challenge in Kaggle, pneumonia detection, Landmark. There are many others that we have done in Kaggle, but Rexis. Rexis is the one that will are there every single year. And this year, the challenge is quite interesting. So I invite you to check it out. Like if you, so this competition will go until, I think, end of June. If my memory is right, but what is interesting is Twitter released a huge amount of data, like a really large data set. I think it's 1 or 2 terabytes of data. But they put you, I mean, they gave you, the task is actually to predict engagement, like the type of engagement that is going to happen with a tweet. And they want to make it fair, which is a pretty difficult challenge in itself. But they put another constraint that is really cool, that is that you will have a computational constraints. You need to be able to run inference in a machine that is relatively small. This is 64 gigabytes RAM with 8 cores, and you need to be able to do it in less than 24 hours. And we're talking about like 10 million rows for the testing data set. And the training data set, as I mentioned before, was 1 terabyte. That is like it in a couple billion rows. So this is a massive data set. So being able to use it to train a model is extremely difficult. And that's where our expertise in like actually doing proper coding, like all our infrastructure is really written in a low level language programming. And we use that in order to be able to actually load 1 terabyte of data in less than 7 minutes. And we are able to process it extremely fast. So we are able to iterate really fast. And this is something that cannot be done just in Python. You really need something better for that. So it's really exciting. And if you see the current leaderboard, most of the positions that you see there is actually us. I don't want to say who exactly is us, but most of them are us. And we are really happy to be participating on this thing again. And we hope to win this challenge this year. We have always ended up in first and second place. So we are aiming for first place this year. Finally, we do have applications. Many of the applications that we do are pro bono. We do them just because we want to help, and we want to help in any place that we find that machine learning can do a contribution. Health is one of them. It's a really difficult space to help. We have published papers when we can actually predict, for example, onset diabetes in a, just from clinical data that just got published recently. We have working with companies related to breast cancer detection and the Kaggle competition about pneumonia. So it's something that is close to us and close to TD, who has invested significant amount of money in this general framework. Now, there is a lot of financial applications, and we heard a lot about the different applications that ML and AI has. My team is in charge of two of these ones. My team handles everything that has to do with fraud and everything that has to do with insurance, but we also handle anything that has to do with NLP and that touches a little bit of digital banking. I cannot tell you details about any of the projects that we have worked on that or that we have deployed. What I can tell you is that we have beat the benchmarks by a significant margin, by over 100% in some cases, and we have beat state of like really big vendors when they come to predictions. And not only that, again, our code is one of our biggest strengths. We can do this really, really fast. Finally, another side of layer six is like research is cool, state of the art is cool, but you really need to be able to teams in production, and you need to create prods that you can replicate and use across many different tasks. So we have a platform, we have our core code, and we keep improving it every single time, and we work a lot on it. So there is a lot of software engineer going on, but it's software engineer with a data science mindset. We improve the pipelines, and we're working in the cloud. We have integrated many pieces in the cloud at this point. And again, like as it was mentioned again in the previous talk, explainability is a big thing for banks and for any regulated environment. So we have built a huge amount of explainability tools that help derive insights for the use cases that are significant in for the lines of business. And we keep it like every time that you have a product, you just keep making it better. So we are, it's not just we built a tool now, we are building, constantly building new tools. And that comes from many new papers, from anything that you see on the archive in this regard, we look at it, and if it is valuable, we implement it.